Good morning. Our greeting to all of our parishioners and to all those who are visiting is taken from our mission statement. Our Eucharistic community at Holy Cross welcomes all to faith in Jesus Christ. Jesus reveals himself to be our shepherd and teacher, the one who heals and cares, the one who leads us to rest and refreshment. When our pursuits lead to encounters with Jesus, new ways of thinking and living become possible. Today's readings may be found in the red worship hymnal, number 1155. This morning, we celebrate with the Zacherl family and their daughter, Mary Christine, as she is welcomed into our church through the sacrament of baptism. The presider at this Eucharist is Father Wheeland. We invite you to focus your attention to the back of the church where Father will welcome the family.
Dear parents, what name do you wish to give your child?
Mary Christine.
And what do you ask of God's church for Mary Christine?
Baptism.
You have asked to have your child baptized. In doing so, you are accepting the responsibility of training her in the practice of the faith. It will be your duty to bring her up to keep God's commandments, as Christ taught us, by loving God and our what you're undertaking.
We do.
And we ask you who are that's where I live, of this church. Are you willing to help the parent duties as Christian? The Christian community welcomes this child with great joy. I claim you for Christ our Savior. Sign of the cross on your forehead and invite your parents and godparents to do the same. Oh, the Father and of the Son and of
please join in the entrance hymn, number 645, There's a Wideness in God's Mercy.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we prepare ourselves for the celebration of this Eucharist, we call to mind our sins. Today, for the penitential rite, we will use the prayer of exorcism for baptism. Let us call to mind our sins. Almighty and ever-living God, you sent your only Son into the world to cast out the power of Satan spirit of evil, and to rescue us from the kingdom of darkness and bring us into the splendor of your kingdom of light. We pray for this child. Set her free from original sin and make her a temple of your glory, and send your Holy Spirit to dwell with her through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. We anoint you with the oil of salvation in Christ our Savior. May he strengthen you with his power, who lives and rules forever and ever. I won't do that anymore. No, don't do that. Glory to God in the highest. Peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy. Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that the course of our world may be directed by your peaceful rule, and that your church may rejoice untroubled in her devotion through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We call forth our kindergarten through fifth graders for the special liturgy of the word.
Reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Woe to the shepherds who mislead and scatter the flock of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, against the shepherds who shepherd my people. You have scattered my sheep and driven them away. You have not cared for them, but I will take care to punish your evil deeds. I myself will gather the remnant of my flock from all the lands to which I have driven them, and bring them back to their meadow. There they shall increase and multiply. I will appoint shepherds for them, who will shepherd them, so that they need no longer fear and tremble, and none shall be missing, says the Lord. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up a righteous shoot to David. As king he shall reign and govern wisely. He shall do what is just and right in the land. In his days Judah shall be saved, Israel shall dwell in security. This is the name they will give him, the Lord our justice. The word of the Lord. The responsorial psalm, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, there's nothing I shall want. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there's nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. The Lord is my shepherd, there's nothing I shall want. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there's nothing. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you who once were far off have become near by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace, he who made both one and broke down the dividing wall of enmity through his flesh, abolishing the law with his commandments and legal claims, that he might create in himself one new person in place of the two, thus establishing peace, and might reconcile both God in one body through the cross, putting that enmity to death by it. He came and preached peace to you who were far off, and peace to those who were near. For through him, we both have access in one spirit to the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The apostles gathered together with Jesus and reported all they had done and taught. He said to them, "Come away by yourselves to a deserted place and rest a while." People were coming and going in great numbers, and they had no opportunity even to eat. So when they went off in the boat by themselves to its deserted place, people saw them leaving, and many came to know about it. They hastened there on foot from all the towns and arrived at the place before them. When he disembarked and saw the vast crowd, his heart was moved with pity for them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd, and he began to teach them many things. The Gospel of the Lord. As I prepared for this homily, as I read this particular gospel, the words jumped out to me, and he saw the vast crowd, and his heart was moved with pity for them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd, and he began to teach them many things. I think our Lord, looking down upon us this past month, must have shaken his head in pity for his people on this earth, as he saw what was happening in our society. A young man went into a predominantly black church in South Carolina. He sat there through a Bible session with the people as they shared and welcomed him into their community. Then he got up and he shot and killed 9 of them because they were black, because of his hatred, because of a hatred that had grown inside himself in which he lost all sense of what was normal, ordinary, and right and just. And he killed these people for no reason whatsoever. This past week, we have all been taken back by the events in Tennessee, where one man who was brought up in this country, who knew the blessings of this country, who should have understood the people around him, went and murdered four Marines and a sailor. Just because of the fact they were recruiting, they were preserving the ability for us to defend ourselves and to be an army that would bring peace into the rest of the world. He killed them, they were unarmed, they were not expecting anything that terrible. Right on our own homeland, we had this terrorist attack that rendered our whole country at a standstill as we mourn those men who died, who gave their life for our country, but never in a way that they would have expected. Even killed a police officer, a man whose only crime was that he was doing his job to keep our city streets safe. He ran after a man who was running away from the police. That man turned and, without any value of life, shot and took the life of a man who was a father, husband, who was a person that worked for peace and justice. Those things must make the Lord look upon us and must see that we are, in a way, like sheep without a shepherd. For those things happen in our world because of the fact that we live in a society that does not teach respect for life. If we can kill the unborn, can we not kill anyone else? Why should we value life at any point in the spectrum of life if we don't respect it in the womb? That whole idea of that cheapness of life that causes people to be shot every day in our city streets, that causes people to think that they have the right. But it is a result of the materialism, the secularism, the whole idea of the repudiating of religion in our country. Our church pews many times are empty. People do not need to feel a need for church. I remember after 9/11, all the churches were commenting on how the attendance at those churches went up. A world of materialism and secularism closed out that voice of God. The violence that is caused by prejudice because we do not understand one another is caused by the ability that we have not to love one another, the ability not to see God in our brothers and sisters. And so therefore we mourn those facts. We look at that. We live in a church that offers us the sacrament of penance, reconciliation. And yet so many people today say, I don't need that. I don't commit sin. And the reality is that sin is all around us. And that if we want to change the world, then we have to find ways of bringing peace and justice into this world. We must find ways of living out the teachings of Jesus and glorifying God. But even in the midst of all the in South Carolina, when they lost 9 of their members, they forgave the man who shot them. The whole idea of forgiveness, the whole idea of the divine mercy of God being personified because of a great evil that happened. And these people rallied together and brought the prayer of God and the strength of God to allow them to forgive and to bring goodness into the world in spite of the darkness. There is that report of that man who was a Muslim and he shot other people because he believed that he had a mission to do that. And so often we wonder, how do people feel about that? So often we're told, well, why don't the Muslims speak out about that? Well, they do, but unfortunately we don't hear it. In Tennessee, all the mosques gather together but to respect life. 4 weeks ago, we had a dedication of a peace park on the north side of our land with the Muslims that have a mosque there. We gathered together, about 60 of them and 60 of us, and the Imam and myself celebrated together a ceremony of calling upon ourselves to be people of peace and to recognize that both communities want peace. And they read from the Quran, and they read the passage that says you cannot take someone's life because you violate the teaching. Violence, that they have been hijacked by those who want to hide behind them and perform violence and hatred. They want us all to hate them so that we'll hate all those people. And that is what we cannot do, that we have to find reason to come together, reason to find that common good that is in each of us, and that all of us recognizing that God is the one who has created all of us, and that we must respect all his creation. But it's interesting, until I started looking for this about the Muslims and how they reacted, I had not read that in the secular press. I have not seen that on television. It is there, but we're not always getting to know the goodness of people, the desire that people have for peace. This past week, when the man who shot Officer Pearson was found guilty and sentenced to life imprisonment without parole, finally his wife spoke out. She, who was at the trial at the end, spoke about the pain, the suffering that this man had caused personally to her, the loss of her husband, the loss of her son and daughter's father, the loss of that love that she had for her husband, and that pain and suffering that was also part of even those who defend us from the evil of this world can be taken down by the hatred of one person and killed and removed from this world. She also talked later about the fact that because of her religion, she had forgiven that man. She had forgiven him, but she wanted justice. She wanted him to face the reality of his crime and be punished for it. She forgave him, and she also said, I'm going to wipe him out of my mind, because I'm not going to let his hatred, his meanness, his cruelty have power over me or over my children or take away from the good of my husband. And I will tell his story, and I will manifest the goodness of my husband to his children so that his spirit of dedication and love may always be seen. She stood to proclaim forgiveness, but also to proclaim justice. So let us look at those people, and let us see that there is hope, but we have to turn to Jesus. We have to call upon him as our shepherd to guide us, to make us willing to suffer for peace, willingness to be able to reach out to others and to show them the real meaning of love, to be out, reach out to those who are prejudiced against and tell them that we love them, to reach out against those who are put down upon by our society and tell them that they are special. That is our responsibility. That is our Christian way of life. And that is what Jesus, our Good Shepherd, is trying to teach us now, to teach us how to overcome evil, to teach us how to live in spite of evil and bring the light of God into the world. Today we are baptizing Mary Christine, and we're going to proclaim our faith as welcoming her into this community, into the church. And as we do that, let us be mindful of what we want to welcome her to. A community that stands for love, a community that breeds peace, a community that understands the call of the gospel to love our neighbor and to reach out to them and minister to them and to bring them goodness. We want to do that so we make a world in which Mary Christine can grow in peace and love, where she truly will hear the promise of Christ and find that love and that strength that she needs to live in this world, in the community of the church. So let us all be mindful of the fact that we can make a difference. We can follow the shepherd. We can be a light to the world, and we can overcome the darkness of evil.
Thank you. sit.
Let us stand. My dear brothers and sisters, we now ask God to give this child new light in abundance through water and the Holy Spirit. You have called this child, Mary Christine, to the cleansing water and new birth by sharing the faith of your church. She might have eternal life. Bless this water in which she is about to be baptized. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Today, in place of the creed, we will renew our baptismal vows. We ask all of you to join with Mary Christine's family in renewing their own vows and speaking for her, the parents and godparents, and all of us renewing our vows to be good members of our community, to live in the love of God, and to influence the world for peace.
I do.
In all his empty promises,
I do.
In all his works,
I
do. Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, and rose from the dead, is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the community of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Dear parents, is it your will that Mary Christine be baptized in the faith of the Church, which we have all professed with you?
Okay.
If the congregation could be seated.
We pray for Pope Francis, all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may lead in faith and serve in love the flock entrusted to their care by Christ the Good Shepherd. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray that God will turn the hearts from violence and open new pathways for safety, peace, and justice in all troubled areas of our world. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for those who serve our country and communities. As they perform their daily duties, the hand of God protects them and delivers them safely home to their loved ones. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray for those affected by the tragic shooting of the Marines in Tennessee, that they will know peace and strength of the Lord in their time of need and will be aware of our compassion and prayers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
we pray for Mary Christine, who has been baptized into our parish family. May she grow in the love and faith of the Catholic Church, inspired by her parents and godparents. We pray to the Lord. We pray that those who are troubled or weary find rest in the Good Shepherd. Let us pray to the Lord. We pray that those who have died will hear his voice and receive his everlasting joy, especially Eleanor Morgan, Rose Marie Mosier, James Kennerson, and for Randy Bianchi and Jenny Mazzola, for whom this Mass is being offered. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pause for a moment and make our own private petitions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, you used even the darkness of this world to teach us the meaning of your light. Help us to have faith in that light and help us to seek through you the blessing of light on our community, that we as church and as world may provide room for Mary Christine to know the love of God and to feel the power of his light that has come upon her this day. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The second collection today is for Holy Cross School. Please join in the offertory hymn number 712, "The King of Love, My Shepherd Is."
Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have the strength to walk, which earth is given in human hands and made. Come for us, the bread of life. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion special offerings of the law, accept, we pray, the sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy, as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that we may each have offered to the honor of your majesty, and it may benefit the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity. Even fashion for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Through him, the host of angels adore your majesty and rejoice in your presence forever. And may our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one choir of exultation praise as we acclaim. Come for us, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his presence, into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you humbly, we pray, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Salvatore, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Spouse Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours,
now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof.
But only say the word,
and my soul shall be healed.
Precious blood of Christ.
Eucharist ministers of communion, bringing communion to the sick, please come forward.
And I'll tell you when to put this on her, okay? And then I'll have you go up, see the candle behind me, the tall candle. Go up and get a light, and I'll tell you when to do that. Did I preach too long? Is that what you're trying to tell me? No. Yeah, here you go. Well, I'm mad and I'm not going to be satisfied with anything but food. Food, food. She's prophesizing, we just don't understand the words. Mary, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. See in this white garment that you are wearing and the one being presented by your godmother and the white garment you are wearing, the outward sign of your Christian dignity. With family and friends, keep that dignity unstained to the everlasting life of heaven. Receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. She is to share always in that light. May she keep the flame of faith alive in her heart. And when the Lord comes, may she go out to meet him with all the saints in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord may the deaf hear and the mute speak. May he soon touch your ears and your word, and that you may hear his word and proclaim his truth to the Father, of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Welcome. Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by the same sacrament which you feed us in present age, you may make us partakers of eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You want to be partaker of food? Yes.
The garage sale that is going on in the school gym continues until 2:30 p.m. today. Next weekend, we welcome Father Anthony Joseph Rex as our guest homilist for the mission appeal. Also next weekend at all the masses, our seminarian Michael Merritt will offer some reflections on his past year at Holy Cross. After each of the Sunday masses next weekend, we will have coffee and donuts, so you'll have the opportunity to wish Michael well as he prepares to return to the seminary early in August. The Holy Cross Festival is quickly approaching, and you can purchase with cash. Ride tickets and food tickets for the festival will be available after and all parish information. There will be a coffee hour after Mass in the parish center today, and our recessional hymn will be number 681, Good Shepherd, You Know Us.
I want to urge you all to buy raffle tickets, food tickets, and anything else you can do to help our festival. Remember, this year we could not mail out our tickets, so the only way you have of getting them into your family is by taking them here from church. Also, then you have to return them with cash. We cannot accept checks for raffle tickets. I know not why, but it's the law. And let us welcome Mary Christine and her family into our family. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And you go right out ahead of me. You're going to come down with the cross. Just wait, wait. Wait to the cut. Even on Sunday, he does it. Whoops, don't cut in front of me. Right, God bless. Yeah, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, good, good. How are you? How are you? How are you? How's everything? Good. Keep in our prayers. Gonna see you Friday, right? Alright. How are you? Huh? I doubt it. Don't play high. Alright. How are you? How are you? How are you? How you doing? How are you? How you been?
We've been really good. This is our brand new
Oh, hi, Ashley. How are you? Yes, how are you?